local webcasting for a worldwide audience.
Greetings, good people. Welcome to the second edition of the Americana Deep Dive. I'm DJ Lonnie, and I'd like to invite you along for a ride into the musical heart of America. We're going to be focusing mainly on contemporary Americana, but taking a trip back in time through early blues and folk, country, bluegrass, honky-tonk, all the great stuff, and playing some wonderful music along the way. So to kick things off in the right fashion, that was the improbably named Moreland and Arbuckle with Tall Boogie, hailing from Wichita, Kansas. These boys were originally a duo with Dustin Arbuckle on vocals and Aaron Moreland on guitar, formed in 2001, and then added Kendall Newby on drums and formed a wonderful powerhouse trio. They've released half a dozen really great records. That was Tall Boogie off their fifth studio album, Seven Cities, from 2013, and a great way to start. They really are a favourite band of mine. Their music is consistently awesome, and everything contemporary hard rock blues should be, in my mind. It's gritty, it's swampy, it's bluesy, it's soulful, and it's lean and mean. Okay, let's stay swampy a little while longer. Here's Edia Victoria with Stuck in the South. Hope you enjoy this one.
I don't know nothing. other hell we stand. Give them cause to take and take.
Distinctly southern gothic blues there. Adia Victoria with Stuck in the South. She's a really interesting artist, originally from South Carolina, now firmly based in Nashville. That track was recorded in 2016, the same year her debut album Beyond the Bloodhounds was released. There's two more records released since then, and all well worth checking out. Okay, next up, a very special track off a superb album. This is Robert Plant and Alison Krauss with Gone, Gone, Gone from the excellent multiple Grammy-winning Raising Sand from 2007. Okay, here we go.
Just say I'm gone, 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 gone.
Crooked Still there with Ain't No Grave from their 2006 album Shaken by a Low Sound. I just love the fresh feel that it has. Nothing like some good old-time religion and awesome banjo and fiddle. Beautiful vocals too. They're really interesting band, Crooked Still. Originally from Boston, they have a well-earned reputation for their musicianship and are a growing force in the world of folk country or what's been dubbed progressive bluegrass. However you want to describe it, their music is clearly steeped in tradition, yet all feels really fresh and lively, and just a beautiful track. Okay, before that was Gone 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 from Plant and Krause, and we'll be sure to return to their artistry further on down the road. Okay, now for something completely different. Here's that very strange kid, C.W. Stone King. I must admit to being a little confused when I first came across this character. A tall, thin, white Australian, sounding as he does, playing this kind of music, but that's straightened out soon enough. Here he is with Rich Man Blues from King Hokum from 2005. King Hokum pretty well describes his shtick. I was also honoured to have witnessed the glory that is a C.W. Stone King gig at the Concord on the Brighton seafront many years ago. Truly magical experience. Okay, here he is.
Sunlight off the leather. I got a shady place to park. I don't got those rich man blues hanging on my mind. Sorry if I left you all behind. again. Because I drive a brand new car. Ain't got no photos in the locket. That's how I got up where I am. I saw got those rich man blues hanging on my mind. Sorry if I left you all behind. I saw got those rich man blues hanging on my mind. Sorry if I left you all behind. Oh, the rich man, yeah.
Okay, that was Cha-Cha the Blues by the legendary Charlie Musselwhite off his 1967 debut album, Stand Back. Here comes Charlie Musselwhite's Southside Band. Without doubt, one of the finest blues harmonica players, surrounded by some great, great musicians as well, extolling the power of Southside Chicago blues. And still blowing hard with contemporary releases, holding up for sure. Notably, a wonderful album he released with Ben Harper in 2013, entitled Get Up, which is really great. Okay, before that was a favourite piece of music of mine, Red Dust by Calexico and Iron and Wine from their In the Rains collaboration of 2005. Just got such a great groove to that. It's one of those tracks that you kind of wish went on for at least 15 minutes, but alas, there it is, all wrapped up. Gotta love Calexico's Baja California Tex-Mex version of Americana, and Sam Bean, who records his Iron and Wine, is certainly a favourite artist of mine, and we'll be hearing lots from both Calexico and Iron and Wine in the Americana Deep Dive programmes up ahead. Okay, next up is another favourite, and that's Aylin Jewell with Where They Never Say Your Name from her 2007 album, Letters from Sinners and Strangers. Hailing from Boise, Idaho, but cutting her teeth busking on the streets of Santa Fe, I do believe. Her debut album, Boundary County, is just gorgeous all the way through, but I'm going to resist the temptation to play anything off that just yet. For now, there's This Wee Sweet Thing, just as a little taster of lots of glory to come.
God make coal for the men who sold their lives to West Van Leer. And you keep on digging till you get down there where it's darker than your darkest fears. And that woman in the kitchen, she keeps on cooking, but she ain't had meat in years. You just live off bread, live off hope and a pool of 1,000,000 tears. Now let me tell you something about the gospel, and make sure that you mark it down. When God spoke out, let there be light, he put the first of us in the ground. And we'll keep on digging till the coming of the Lord and Gabriel's trumpet sounds. 'Cause if you ain't mining for the company, boy, there ain't much in this town. We could have made something of ourselves out there if we'd have listened to the folks that knew that coal was gonna bury you. Darker than a dungeon, and it's deeper than a well. So sometimes I imagine that I'm getting pretty close to hell. And in my darkest hour, I cry out to the Lord. He says, keep on a mining, boy, 'cause that's why you were born. We could have made something of ourselves out there if we'd have listened to the folks that knew that coal was gonna bury you.
I was Tyler Childers with Coal, another fine example of what, in my mind at least, is at the heart of Americana. Stories of real lived experiences of hardworking folk, dirt poor farmers and coal miners and the like, set to sincerely produced songs with beautiful instrumentation. And there's hardships and struggles, and importantly, there's lots of faith. That track is from the appropriately titled Bottles and Bibles from 2011, and it's just wonderful, with lots of traditional country and bluegrass and bluesy folk, and listening to it just makes you feel like you're in Kentucky. Either that or the damn fine bourbon you should be drinking while listening to it. But all his stuff is well worth seeking out. And so to an artist that will appear regularly in these shows, Mr. J.J. Cale. This is another beautiful track of his Troubadour album of 2006, and it's dedicated to my beautiful wife, Nikki.
Thank you.
The Be Good Tanyas there with their sublime version of Neil Young's For the Turnstiles. Really beautiful harmonies and such a breezy vibe. I do love it when artists take on iconic songs and manage to create beautiful versions in their own style. Exactly like that one. That's off their 2006 album Hello Love. There's so much great stuff on that album and others too, so we shall meet again. And before that, Mr. J.J. Cale with Let Me Do It To You. We miss the man, but we have his music. Okay, time to turn back to some classic blues now. Here's the one and only Slim Harpo with Shake Your Hips from 1966. Love the Stones' take on this classic track, of course. But it's got something else about it, something so pure and sweet. And if I ever need to get moving in the mornings, this is my go-to. Works every time.
I want to tell you about a dance that's going around. Everybody doing it, from the grown-ups down. We have to move your head, we have to move your hands, we have to move your lips, just shake your hips, and do the hip shake, baby, and do the hip shake, baby, do the hip shake, baby, shake your hips, baby. Now if you don't know, don't be afraid, just listen to me. Shake your hips, do the hip shake, baby, do the hip shake, baby, do the hip shake, baby, shake your hips, baby, now ain't that easy.
Just heard two wonderful blues tracks with a similar kind of get up and go vibe to them. There's Slim Harpo with Shake Your Hips, followed by the awesome Jessie Mae Hemphill with Jump Baby Jump from her She-Wolf record from 1981. And along with R.L. Burnside and Junior Kimbrough, Jessie Mae's certainly one of the foremost purveyors of North Mississippi Hill Country blues, a particular type of blues that forgoes the more conventional structures of blues music by hitting on a groove and staying there a long while, which is just great by me. And arguably the finest proponents of that kind of thing in the world of contemporary Americana is the Rose City Band, another project of perhaps my favourite guitarist right now, Ripley Johnson, frontman of the awesome Wooden Ships and the equally magnificent and even more psychedelic Moon Duo. In fact, this is where we came in. I was playing this next track at my place of work, a cafe restaurant I run with my wife in Brighton's Kemptown, and the Southern Blonde herself, Lisa Lyles of the A&E show here on Radio Lewes, was dining and enjoying the sounds. And we bonded over Ripley, and she suggested I get involved with these shows. So either thank her or blame her, but this one is dedicated to Lisa. Here's the Rose City Band with Summer Long, from 2020, and I shall leave you with this gorgeous piece of breezy 70s California-tinged guitar glory. Until next time, stay safe, keep on rocking, adios.
Long time.
Radio Lewes. Local. Community. Webcasting.